Toastmaster up next. She says that looking at the good helps her in her role as the City of Calgary's IT Incident Management Process Manager. She is a distinguished Toastmaster who enjoys competing in that field, and she openly admits that her hobbies are both odd and old. Please welcome Joanne Smith.
Back in 1997, my family and I made a choice. We decided to move to the coastal mountains. We were surrounded by mountains. There was a river running through it. It was a place called Canal. It was beautiful. In that town, we got to see many different types of wildlife. We had bears coming into town. We had wolves coming into town. That is my very first fish that I ever caught. And it seems I'm hooked now. We also had lots of wonderful organizations like Scouts and others. But unfortunately, not all choices are our own. The town, the company that owned it, Alcan, decided to close it. So instantly, we now had no home, no place to live, no income. But that was okay. It gave us lots of other choices. One of the choices Alcan made was to send us away for training. Another choice they made was to burn down the houses. Now that allowed the firefighters all up along the West Coast to learn to fight true fires. So it gave them some amazing practice. Myself, I decided to come to Calgary. I decided it's time for me to retrain. It was a great opportunity, but Calgary, for a person that has been living in a place of 185 people, is a little scary. I felt extremely alone. You see, my family was still in D.C. My husband was feeding my children every day for 9 months, steak, potato, and salad. When they finally came to Calgary, they begged me for pasta and for rice. But the loneliness when I was here changed a little bit because of one woman on the sea train. As she got up and left, she smiled at me and said, "Have a wonderful day." And instantly, I felt better. Even going to classes that day, I was uplifted. I was smiling all the time. And I realized that if I smiled at a stranger every day and said, "Good morning," or "Have a wonderful day," that it would uplift their spirits too. And it did make a difference. All of a sudden, I didn't feel so alone. But on the other hand, some of my friends thought I was a little crazy. And that's okay. They didn't have to do what I did. But that smile that I give everybody every day, and that hello, even to complete strangers and street people, has changed my life. But there are times when we are given choices, and there are times when we wish that others would make a choice. I'm going to ask you to put up your hand. If, has anyone asked you, what do you want for supper? All right. For the rest of you, has anyone asked you, have you ever responded, what do I want for supper? All right, well, the next question is simple, because I ask this to my husband all the time, and I get these strange answers. Shout out to me some of the responses you give to your spouse.
I don't know.
That one's not on my list. But my husband, he loves to respond with things that just irritate me. So I've decided that I'm going to create a cookbook. This, ladies and gentlemen, is whatever you want. It is French toast with bourbon-infused apples and brie stuffed in between. But whenever he asks, and then responds with whatever you want, this is what he's going to get. This, ladies and gentlemen, is I don't care. Now, I don't care is a mixture meat that he doesn't necessarily like. Potatoes and sweet potatoes, which he hates. But whenever he responds, I don't care, that's what he's going to get. This is what's ever easiest to make. It is a cucumber salad with feta and avocado and cheese, and I love it, but he hates it for dinner. This is you choose. Now for me, I love soup. Soup is the best dinner ever. Now I know he's a guy and he wants steak and potatoes, but he answered, you choose. This is what he's getting. Now there are times when he doesn't even respond. I get the shoulder shrug. That's what he gets for shoulder shrug. Now my children also did this and they didn't mind macaroni and cheese. He hates it. But you see, I have an ulterior motive. When he cooks, I get leftovers. I don't like leftovers. I would much prefer a different response from, what would you like for dinner? Every once in a while, I'd like them to respond a little more positively. So, I would like to hear, dear, I've made reservations at your favorite restaurant, and you can take your time getting ready. Now, it doesn't have to be in Paris, but I would like, just for once in a while, to change it up. I'm going to ask you, I smile at a total stranger's every day. Try it. See if you can be as happy as I am with them. And if you want answers to that age-old question, what do you want for breakfast? Create your own cookbook.